welcome back to On The Volley, OTV for sure, where we talk about all things football. Now, before we talk about the Celtic game against St. Johnstone, we'd like to give out our condolences to the family of Bertie Ault. A great loss to society. He was a legend. He was one of the Lisbon Lions. And unfortunately, you know, all we can talk about now is the memories and his famous quotes. He'll definitely be missed. Our thoughts and prayers are with him. Can't really say more than that. There's really nothing we can do in this situation. But just as long as their family know, his family knows, sorry, okay, right, that our thoughts and prayers are with them. Okay, so let's go on to what we're going to say about the game. But before we go to the game itself, I have to remember to give a shout out to JohnBoy67 Graham. Okay, and that's his name on the YouTube channel. So, yo, bro, there's your shout out as promised. As you know, I always keep my promises. So, there you have it. Anyway, I'm lucky tonight. Okay, we're at the Finnegan's. Okay, the Celtic pub in Rome. And I have the pleasure to be with Stephen. Okay. Perfect. I've got it right. You know, I'm a little bit worried here. My memory goes. Okay. And Orla. Did I pronounce that right?
Close enough.
Look. I'm known on the channel for crucifying. Okay, no. Names and surnames.
The way you say
Orla.
That is perfect. Orla.
Okay. Orla. Perfect. Orla. Okay. Ooh. I saved myself there. Yeah. And we've just finished watching the Premier Sports Cup. I always used to call it the League Cup. The Premier Sports Cup semi-final. So it is. So I wasn't wrong.
Call it the League Cup.
Okay, League Cup. Oh, so I can call it the League Cup. Oh, thank God for that. I thought I was wrong. Okay, so I'm going to stick with the semi-final of the League Cup, yeah, where Celtic won 1-0. Now, I want your views.
Oh, no.
On the game.
I can't remember.
We always have someone.
I can't remember the Liverpool score. Was it 4-0?
He's a git. I'll have a word with you later. You're a big boy, but I'll have a word with you later, son. Anyway, as everyone knows, yeah, in England I support Arsenal. In Scotland I support Celtic. Unfortunately, he's a Londoner from North London. North London that supports Liverpool. You work out.
Scotland.
Exactly. Anyway, let's get back to it. So, Stephen, what was your opinion on the game?
It's a difficult game. St. Johnstone, they won the double last year.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to be defensive, try to defend the trophy. Callum Davidson, probably manager of the season last year. Steven Gerrard stole that trophy off him. But defensive. As soon as they have to get our first goal, it's gone.
Okay.
Attacking wise, nothing St. Johnstone really offered. They had that wee blunder that Joe Hart had.
What do you think?
Listen, I was a bit nervous at the start considering the fact that I feel like, I always say this to Stephen, if Celtic don't score in the first half, I get nervous because I'm like, look, if we're not going to score in the first half, it means it's going to be 0-0 or we're going to concede a goal.
It's typical Angie fashion. If Celtic don't put the pressure on in the first half by a goal, it's going to be a sweat. It's a couple of sweaty sides in the second half. But James Forrest, I mean, missed 80% of the season last season. Comes on, scores his goal, automatic, instantly right into Celtic for goal. He's a hero, man. I love him, man. I love James Forrest.
Okay, but let me ask you two a question, yeah? Okay, right. I mean, okay, we're going to the end of the first half, 0-0. Celtic probably should have been up. Okay, 2-0.
Yeah.
Okay, I mean, Turnbull had a great opportunity. Okay, that pass from Jota. And I don't know how he just skied that, yeah? He should have just placed it into the corner, yeah? So, you know, we missed a couple of chances. But to be totally honest, was you worried that Celtic wouldn't score in the second half?
I mean, it's the type of football that St. Johnstone play. They make sure that they're not worried. There's that defensive that you know that they're not an attacking threat. So, they're not worried that St. Johnstone are going to get a good one.
Okay.
Like, you've got that Joe Hart wonder, that's it. You've got Celtic all weekend set pieces. But in the first half, it's what the percentage in possession was 80-20. 80% of Celtic. You just know that they're not getting a chance in the game. They're not even going to get allowed a sniff.
Yeah, they're not even going to get a pin. Like, same with the amount of possession we had. I feel like that was like the most comforting, if anything, like even though we didn't like score to the point, I just feel like because of the amount of possession we had, it was a lot more comforting, and the fact that we would have probably by the second half we were going to have a lot of pin.
So was you worried or wasn't you? That's what I want to understand.
I feel like when it gets to a certain part in the first half, you're all like, oh, do you know what I mean? You're like, oh, this might not go the way we want it, but I feel like after that second half, once we've had the break, once we've had the kind of, you know, the motivation, they've had the spoken to and whatever else, I just feel like that build up is just as good as the first half, and it just gets built up, and I just feel like we probably just had the same amount of opportunity as the start, the kind of the first half as well.
We've got that bit of dimmer now, like this season, Celtic have already shown it, like, if they don't score early, then they're going to struggle. So, against Livingston, the 0-0 draw, like, personally, when I watched that game, half-time, we knew exactly what was happening. We'll get a point in the game. Celtic are scoring, Livingston are defending it. But it had a different feel, but like, Celtic were creating too many chances to not let me worry. Like, you knew Celtic were getting a goal in this game. So Johnson, they had nothing going forward, absolutely nothing. There's no worry about it.
Look, I agree with you on that 100%, but I don't think that today we can take the Livingston game as an example. And the reason for that is we all know what Ange had as a resource, okay, resources that he had, the players they had available, yeah? He didn't have a first team. Too many people were out, injured, not available, okay? You know, too many new players in that had to get to know each other. I personally, okay, you know, I've researched Ange, okay, and I saw, and we discussed this before, okay, right, when Ange was basically announced as a manager, most of the Celtic fans were not happy because he's an unknown. And that's understandable, you know, that's understandable. You know, they were expecting Eddie Howe. And they get Ange Postecoglou. Personally, I think Celtic dodged a bullet with Eddie Howe, yeah? Okay. And like I said in a past podcast, Ange had interviews with other European clubs, yeah? And they turned him down because he's an unknown quantity. So that's acceptable, that's understandable. But I think if you look at how Celtic have been playing, how they've progressed, yeah?
Yeah.
Me as a Celtic fan, I wasn't worried at all. And this is what I agree with you. St. Johnson showed nothing. You know, it was all down to Celtic.
Yeah.
Okay? Jota had a very, very good first 15 minutes. I mean, he was roasting them, yeah?
Tricky.
Yeah. But then I think we made it a little bit hard work of it, you know, in the middle section. What do you think of that?
It's typical Celtic. It's all attack, attack, attack. Callum McGregor, he's the Celtic captain.
So if I stop you, is that typical Celtic? Or is that typical Ange Postecoglou?
It's typical Ange, to be honest. He brings his fullbacks into the middle. And it turns into a bit, like, almost of a firefight in some scenarios. In the case of St. Johnson and the typical team that are just counting on getting that ball from the middle of the park. They had their chance from a couple of lucky interceptions, pretty much. A couple of straight passes, misplaced passes, but to be honest, the middle of the park, they never really showed any interest to me. Like, straight up forward.
Did we deserve to win?
I 100%.
So we agree on that.
Unlucky to not get a few more.
I agree.
Especially in the first half. Going into half time. It should have been Celtic leading going into the first half at least.
Yeah.
At least going into the first half.
You're saying that St. Johnson's specialty is to defend
there. Yes. It's St. Johnson's defend.
Yeah.
Callum Benson, I mean, I'm not gonna take any credit away from Callum Benson, but what he achieved last year is a spectacle. It's unbelievable. It's what, St Johnstone's first trophy, and then they win the double. To not win manager of the year, it's disgraceful. In a way, I mean, the man's up there, but Celtic knew, Celtic fans knew exactly what type of game they were going to get today, and it's exactly what they got. Celtic on top.
Yeah. Well, let's go to the next question I've got. Ange has taken Celtic to their first final. And I think there's a lot more to come from Ange, yeah. Tomorrow Rangers are playing Hibernian. Who do you think's going to win tomorrow?
I mean, it's hard to say, especially with the patchy face that Rangers have gone through.
Yeah.
Like, they've got a habit of conceding first recently. Constantly going into league games conceding first. Obviously, to show why they were champions last season. They're going out, they're getting 3 points after that. Going down 1-0, going out, getting the points. So, heads, they've been in good form this season. But we've shown teams that they can compete in that top four. So, I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if I had to go out and get them again. Obviously, Giovanni Van Bronckhorst just signed for Rangers for full-time coach. I'm not 100% sure, but I've heard that he's not going to be in the stands tomorrow. So, that'll be the Rangers going in without their new manager. So, it's something that I'd say it's up for grabs for Hibs.
So you think Hibs will win tomorrow?
I think it's up for grabs for Hibs. It's up to Hibs to go out and show. Listen, we can compete against Joes, especially when it's almost like an injured Rangers shown.
Okay.
Yeah.
What about you?
I'd probably say the same. It's kind of up and on tomorrow, especially with like a new manager. Do you know what I mean? The fans are kind of trying to adapt. I think it is really kind of up and on. So if we can win, do you know what I mean? And as Stephen said, it's not even going to be in the stands. So I think it's really going to be the same. We don't care.
I'm not even sure who's going to be at the stand for Rangers, to be honest. I heard that Jermaine Defoe and all that is part of the backroom staff.
Yeah.
But in terms of who's going to be leading Rangers tomorrow, I couldn't even tell you, to be honest.
I'll be honest, I'm not interested. I haven't even gone to have a look. I'm sorry, no offence to the Rangers fans, yeah? But I'm concentrating on Celtic. But I predict a Rangers Celtic final.
Don't get me wrong, I would love that.
To be honest, it'd be some game, I'll be in about that, trying to get a couple for that, but...
Yeah.
That's what I'm predicting.
Anyone would want that, you know, I think we definitely would say probably for Rangers to get through and have a, you know,
Celtic
victory.
It'd
be great, yeah.
It'd be great.
Great atmosphere,
great.
It would be, yeah, fantastic.
Not been in a cup final together since the exact same league trophy in 2019. Well, Celtic obviously won 1-1.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
And what a day that was.
Yeah.
So,
straight to
repeat. So let's hope that we have a repeat of that with a Celtic win. Anyway, I think we can close this section. I'd like to thank Stephen and Orla. Okay, right, I hope I pronounced that right. Okay. It's been a pleasure meeting you two here. You're on holiday, aren't you? Okay. And where did they come? To the Celtic pub in Rome, Finnegan's, in the centre of Rome. Anyway, so Steve, if you want to just say you're out.
Thank you for having me on your show. Appreciate it.
My pleasure.
It's been a pleasure. I'm so happy to be in Rome. So thank you so much for coming as a part of this.
Well, listen, thank you very much for watching us. If you like, please press like. And if you haven't subscribed as yet, please subscribe. Any comments, put it in the comment section. You know I try to reply to all the comments. I still haven't sorted out the technical problem with the comments when I put a comment in and it says reply added and then it just doesn't show. I haven't seen my boys yet because I've been away in Milan on work, business, okay? That's why I didn't do a pre-match podcast, which I did want to do. But hey, I've got work to do, so, you know, this is something we do in our spare time, if you like. It's not 24 hours a day, as you well know, as I've stated in the past. Please feel free to share. Misha, I'm out.